Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to my workshop. This week, I've got an unexpected repair I need to perform on my CNC mini mill. And while I'm at it, I'm going to show you some of the upgrades and modifications I've made over the years. So this is our mini mill, sometimes called the X2 mini mill. It's sold by a number of different vendors under different names. But this one was actually purchased brand new, already retrofitted for CNC. Now, there's lots of videos out there of people retrofitting these ones, but this was actually a factory retrofit by Sieg America. And it's a little bit different than a lot of the retrofits I see out there. Some of the retrofits I see, they actually have a Z-axis screw going down the side. This one is actually integrated into the column. The only problem we've ever had with it was the coupling between the motors and the lead screw. There must be some misalignment, and I've looked at it several times and haven't been able to really figure out what the problem is. But these couplings, they continually crack on us. So finally ended up swapping them out with this style of coupling, and that has basically eliminated that problem. Now, I've previously replaced the coupler on the Y-axis quite a while ago, and just recently discovered that the X-axis had the same problem. So I'm going to go ahead and swap that out today. Fairly straightforward operation, just removing the cover and then disconnecting the motor. Now, I didn't know I even had this problem until I went looking for it. This machine spends its entire life milling lightweight aluminum, and the friction of the two pieces of the coupler together were enough to not cause me any problems. so there's a few other upgrades to this machine that I've done over the years that are probably worth mentioning. At the head of the list is probably this belt drive conversion. It replaces the existing plastic gear train in the spindle with a two-step belt, which takes the high-end speed from the stock 2500 RPM up to 4300 RPM. So that's a huge improvement. Now, the bed on this one, we've actually modified. We took the bed off of here, put it on another milling machine, and indexed and drilled and tapped holes in the top every 1 inch. What I use these for is basically indexing our fixtures. So I can throw this fixture plate up here, screw in a screw in the appropriate hole, and it's going to index where I need it to be, so I don't have to do a lot of time setting up this fixture, and I can switch from one fixture to another without a problem. Another modification I've done, when I had the table off of the mill to drill these holes, I also machined the back of the table so that I could put this rail in. That gives me yet another thing to index against, because this machine, I really set it all up for production of a few things here we make here in the shop, so I wanted it to be easy to switch between the different products and easily index without having to measure each time what I was doing and setting the fixtures up. Another modification I've done is back here in the back of the machine, the X and Y sensors for the home positions have been replaced with these inductive prox sensors. I really like the idea of having no moving parts so that I have a consistent home position. It's times like these when you realize just how much you need to clean your machine. Hey, if you like this kind of video, hit that thumbs up. And while you're there, hit that subscribe button. That's about it for today. I'll catch you next week.